Yeah, so thanks for coming to the Temporal Graph Reading Group today, everyone. And we're very glad to have Veronica today, who will be presenting their recent work, Graph Neural Networks for Temporal Graphs, the State of the Art, Open Challenges and Opportunities, which is also published at TMLR. And Veronica Lachi is a PhD candidate in Engineering and Information Sciences at the University of Siena. She received a master's degree in applied mathematics from the University of Siena. And her research interests are centered around geometric deep learning and specifically focusing on the theoretical properties of graph neural networks and pooling in GNNs as well as GNNs for temporal graphs. So I will hand the mic to you, Veronica.
Thank you very much. Thank you for the presentation and thank you for having invited me here. Just let me share the screen. Can you see it?
Yes, we can see the screen. Yeah.
Very much. So today we present his work, Graph Neural Networks for Temporal Graphs, State of the Art, Open Challenges and Opportunities. And this work has been done in collaboration with Antonio Longa, Gabriele Santin, Monica Bianchini, Bruno Lepi, Pietro Liò, Franco Scarcelli and Andrea Passerini. So the ability to process temporal graphs is becoming really important for several fields like recommendation systems, social network analysis, epidemic modeling and so on. Traditional graph-based methods are not well suited for analyzing temporal graphs. And so in the last few years, several different methods have been proposed to deal with the temporal graphs, like for example, random walk-based methods, matrix factorization-based methods, and so on. Recently, also graph neural network-based approach has been proposed. And in this work, we have focused on GNN approaches for temporal graphs. What do we mean by temporal graph neural networks or TGNN? With this word, from now on, I will mean all the approaches that deal with temporal graphs by using these message passing mechanisms. So basically, GNN store the information contained in a node V into a feature vector H, which is iteratively updated, aggregating all the information contained in the neighboring nodes. So in this work, we consider and we analyze all the approaches that analyze temporal graph, process temporal graphs that use this kind of message passing mechanism. In particular, our main contributions are the following. So we propose a formalization of the different learning settings and the different tasks that exist in literature. And we also try to formalize all the informal definition that exists about temporal graph neural network. Then we organize the existing temporal graph neural networks into a comprehensive taxonomy. And finally, we highlight the limitations of current temporal graph neural networks. And we also discuss about some open challenges that can be addressed for future work in temporal graph neural networks. So as I said before, one of the main contributions of our work is that of providing formal definitions of temporal graphs and their different representations. So in particular, we try to organize, to structure in a unique framework all the existing notion of temporal graph existent in literature. So let's first of all start from the general definition of temporal graphs. So a temporal graph is a tuple, VE, VT, ET, where V and E are the set of all nodes and the set of all edges that appear in the graph at any time. So basically, these two sets are the set of the entities of node and edges, while VT and ET are the temporal nodes and the temporal edges. So basically, these sets are the contains the tuple that represent the entities of the node together with a temporal time interval in which these nodes or edges exist, and the feature in which that this node or edge brings in that particular time interval. This is the definition of general definition of temporal graphs. General temporal graphs can have any values of time. So for sake of simplicity, we assume that these values of time are positive. And in literature, there are two main ways of representing these temporal graphs. They are namely the snapshot-based representation and the event-based representation. These two different ways of representing graphs are important, especially for the rest of the presentation, especially for the taxonomy that we created, because these different two ways of representing temporal graphs leads to different algorithmic approaches. And so based on this, we create the first level of our taxonomy. So when a snapshot-based temporal graph is just a sequence of static graphs. So in this case, we have that the temporal information is encapsulated solely on the order in which the static graphs follows each other in this sequence. In some applications, it makes sense to force the time values to be a multiple of a fixed time step. And the snapshot-based representation is mostly used for this kind of situation where each snapshot represents the temporal graphs captured at a certain periodic interval, like for example, hours, days, weeks, and so on. The event-based representation are instead more appropriate for representing the temporal evolution of single nodes or single edges. So an event-based temporal graph is a stream of events where these events can be a node insertion, a node deletion, an edge insertion, or an edge deletion. We assume that these events are consistent with each other. So, for example, if we have a node deletion event, then this implies that you have also some edge deletion events, and in particular that the edges that are incident to the node that has been deleted are also deleted. This kind of representation, as I said before, is useful in particular for when you have the information of time that is attached to the nodes or to the edges. And so in this case, the time intervals can also not be regular. So there is not this restriction about the time intervals. For the following part, so after this formalization of the definition, we formalize all the possible existing learning settings and learning tasks that can be performed with temporal graph neural networks. And for this part, we use the general definition of temporal graph neural network, of temporal graph, sorry. While for the taxonomy, we will use these two different definitions of snapshot-based and event-based. So, temporal graph neural networks are very flexible and they can be used for a wide range of tasks. Some of these tasks are just a straightforward temporal extension of their static counterpart, while some other tasks are more complicated in the temporal domain. And so somehow the temporal dimension has some non-trivial consequences on how we can define learning settings and learning tasks on temporal graph. Moreover, we have that some particular learning tasks are just loosely defined in literature. So we try to formalize all the possible learning settings and tasks that can be performed on temporal graphs with the temporal graph neural networks. And we start with the difference between inductive and transductive settings for temporal graphs. So in machine learning literature, there is this distinction between inductive learning, in which a model is learned in training data and later applied to some unseen test instances, and transductive learning, where the input data of both training and test are available during the training. And then the learning is equivalent to try to use the labels that you have in the training in order to make some inference for the label that you don't have, but still you have the inputs in the training. This distinction is becoming also more important when talking about learning on graphs, because the graph topology gives rise to a natural connection between nodes. And that's also to a way of propagating the information in a transductive fashion. And so for graph neural network, also this distinction between inductive and transductive learning is not that sharp. In general, we can say that in inductive learning, you start from graphs where you have some nodes and some topology of the graph. You learn a model on this graph, and then you apply the model that you have learned on these instances to unseen instances. And these unseen instances can be, for example, new node in the same graph. And in this case, the model is used for node level tasks like node classification or node regression, while it can be used also on completely new graphs. And generally, inductive learning is used for graph level tasks with graph neural networks. On the other hand, transactive learning is a little bit different because you start from a graph. You have all the instances, but some labels of some instances are not available during the training. So you learn a model just with the labels that you have. And then you use the model that you have learned in order to infer, to predict the label of the nodes that are seen during the training, but without the label. As I said before, this distinction is not that sharp because you can imagine that you can use the graph neural network in a transactive way. You can learn, you can train a graph neural network in a transactive way, but then you can use this model to predict the property, the label of unseen node. And in this case, you are effectively performing an inductive learning. This distinction is even more elusive, more difficult when there is also the temporal dimension, because node can appear or disappear due to the temporal evolution of the graphs. So we claim that for temporal graphs, with temporal graph neural networks, you, beside the distinction between inductive and transductive learning, there is also another distinction that is between past prediction and future prediction. And we claim that all the possible combination of this modality can be performed with graph neural networks. In particular, we can have future transductive learning, future inductive, past transductive, and past inductive. We can see all the combination more closely with this figure. So in this figure, we have this temporal graph that is represented as a snapshot-based temporal graph. The red nodes are the training nodes, while the green nodes represent the inference node. So this first possibility is the future transductive learning. And in this case, the inference node has been seen also during the training, but without the label, topologically speaking, while temporally speaking, all the training nodes have been seen before the inference time. For the future inductive learning, instead, we have that also in this case, all the training nodes have been seen before the inference time, but the inference node have not been seen during the training. So the nodes are new. And you can see in the figure because dotted lines connects node the different instances of the same node. Another possibility is that of past transductive learning, in which the time of the prediction is in the past with respect to the training nodes, and the nodes of the inference node have been seen during the training. The last possibility is inductive past learning, and in this case, topologically speaking, the node on which we perform inference have not been seen during the training, but they are the prediction is made in a past time. As I said before, all these possible combinations are feasible with temporal graph neural networks, except for inductive graph level task, because in this case, for inductive graph level task, the distinction between future and past is pointless, because basically the temporal information is relative to a certain graph. And so if you have a completely new graph, the information about future or past with respect to something that you have learned in your training set is completely pointless. So the only case in which this combination is not useful is for graph level task, inductive graph level task. Yes?
Can I ask a question?
Yes, of course.
I think it's very interesting about the graph level task, but I think let's say you have a distribution of temporal graphs that mm-hmm. are in the same domain. Let's say you have 10,000 social network, they all happen around the same time, sample from similar distribution,
Okay.
then I think there might be possible to transfer to an inductive, because the underlying evolution mechanism might be graph agnostic. So there might be some, like the nodes might not be transferable, but what you're learning on the nodes about how the edges are added, like does the node degree follow a power law or these kind of things, could be
Yeah.
shared across graphs.
Yeah,
But
but the
that's very
point.
tricky to define.
Yeah, okay, I agree. But the point is, I don't know if I, yes, I think I can, I understood what you said. But the point is that, yes, you can perform inductive graph learning. It's okay. But then it's not that, so the distinction between future and past is not that, it's like, let's say, not so useful, okay? But of course, you can do inductive graph learning and transfer this kind of things on other graphs, yes. So the
Yeah,
point
that
is
makes sense.
future and
Okay,
past. But yes, of course, graph inductive task, you can do it, yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. And so let's talk about the tasks. So always looking with this difference between inductive, transductive, past, and future, we have also defined all the different tasks that you can perform on temporal graphs with temporal graph neural network. So the most common task is the classification or regression one. And of course, also in this case, the most common is the node classification or regression. And in this case, the aim of the task is that of learning a function that assigns to each pair node time a class. And of course, you can switch to a regression task just by substituting the set of all possible classes with R, even if it's less explored in literature. So there are a lot of temporal graph neural networks model proposed to solve node classification tasks, in particular future transductive node classification tasks. So a lot of work, as you can see. And among these works, just the last one, so the work by Cini and others, perform a regression task or on node level. Also, there are some work about that perform node classification in future inductive learning and also in past inductive learning. There are no works, no temporal graphs methods that perform past transductive node classification or regression. But we think that indeed this can be that this can have some interesting application. Like for example, try to so imagine that you can construct a temporal graph using the contact tracing, and then you can attach a label to each node based on sample testing. And then you maybe are interested in try to understand if in the past some of the node that are not tested were infectious or not. So this is an application that can be performed with a temporal graph neural network. Maybe there can be some good insight using a temporal graph neural network models, but no existing models have are proposed to solve this kind of past transductive node classification task. Also, another task is age classification and regression. In this case, the aim is, as before, that of learning a function that associates age and time to a certain class. And also in this case, there are some temporal graph neural networks that work on future transductive edge classification, while no other method, for example, are proposed for future inductive edge classification. But also in this case, there are some possible interesting applications, like for example, try to detect if a transaction between new users is a fraud transaction or not. For another example is the example of past transductive in the social networks. So try to understand what kind of relationship there was between the two seen users. The last possibility is the graph regression or classification. This task is very less, very few explored in literature. There is just one work, that is the work by Micheli, that solved the graph classification problem in a past transductive setting. There are some other possible applications, like try, for example, future inductive applications instead of try to detect mental disease using the brain connectome analysis, that this task has been performed with other models analyzing temporal graphs, but not with temporal graph neural networks, for example. Always in the realm of supervised learning, another relevant task is the link of time prediction. The link prediction task aim at learning a function that assign a probability of existence between of on the on an edge between two nodes. So in this case, the domain of the function is not the possible edge, because you may be interested in detecting the presence of a link between two nodes that were not be connected in the past. And so in this case, the task is transductive if both the nodes have been seen during training, and is inductive otherwise. Several works have addressed with temporal graph neural networks this task, especially in future transductive modality, while also for future inductive there are some work, also for past inductive, ma nobody has studied the past transductive link prediction task. And also in this case, it can be interesting for some application. For example, you can detect missing interaction between patients for epidemic surveillance. Another possibility is that of predict the first time of appearance of a certain link, and also this can be interesting for some application, like for example, try to understand how long does it take for two similar users to be connected in a social network, or try to understand when a customer will pay an invoice. And this task has not been explored yet with the temporal graph neural network, so it's a completely new task with temporal graph neural networks. Going to unsupervised learning, of course, the most important task is clustering. In this case, the aim of temporal graph neural network, instead of learning a function that clusters together group of similar nodes. This task has not been explored yet with temporal graph neural network, but it can be interesting also in this case for disease clustering or for customer profiling or for epidemic modeling. Also, temporal graph clustering can be interesting and is not explored. And for example, it can be interesting to try to understand how to group social interaction networks. And as I said before, in this case, this task can be defined as inductive, but we cannot say if this is future or past. We just say that it's an inductive graph clustering.
Veronica,
Yes.
Can I add something? So this is
Yes.
Junior. In terms of clustering for nodes, have you seen blockchain clustering articles? Because there is a large literature on this. They cluster Bitcoin addresses, Ethereum addresses, and so on. So you mentioned that it's not explored, but there is work going on there.
Okay. Okay, this is the work that we explored so far is just until the last year, but I don't know, maybe I know that there are several works on this, but I don't know if they are addressed with the temporal graph neural network. So maybe temporal graphs algorithm, okay, but as far as I know, the one that we read about, they didn't use GNN. So temporal graph algorithms, yes, but not GNN. But maybe in the last month, maybe there is some new works that use also GNN. So maybe we can, this work is from like last year. So maybe we can have some more models now, and I can check, of course.
Thank you.
Thank you. So another contribution of our work is that of producing a taxonomy of the existing temporal graph neural networks. In order to create this taxonomy, the first dimension that we consider is the difference between the representation that I mentioned before, so snapshot-based representation and event-based representation. So the first branch of our taxonomy is comprise all the model that uses snapshot-based representation. And coherently with the definition of snapshot-based graphs, these methods are equipped with a mechanism that is able to encode, to process each static graph, and then with a mechanism that is able to process the temporal dependencies between static graphs. There are also two other categories in these macro categories. The first category is the model evolution category. In this category, we have that the way in which we process the information of this graph is just a GNN. So you can have different kind of GNN, for example, GGN, GAT, and so on, but the single graph is processed with a GNN. And then the temporal evolution is about the parameter of this GNN. So you have the GNN that learns the static graphs, and then you have a recurrent mechanism that learns the time dependencies of the parameters of each GNN. And to the best of our knowledge, there is just one method that uses this kind of mechanism, that is evolved GCN. And this method uses RNN for this recurrent mechanism. The other category is the embedding evolution. So in this case, we have that as before, the single static graphs is processed with graph neural networks, but then the recurrent mechanism is not on the parameter of this graph neural network as for the model evolution methods, but is on this representation that the GNN has learned. So there is this recurrent mechanism that learns the time dependencies between the different representations learned by the static GNN. There are several works in this category. We report some of this work here. And all of these methods differ for each other because of the internal mechanism that they used for this recurrent mechanism. So, for example, some use LSTM or maybe a attention mechanism and so on. The other macro categories of temporal graph neural networks is the event-based macro categories. So in these macro categories, there are all the temporal graph neural network methods that works with stream of events. So they have some mechanism that deals with these streams of events. This category can be divided into two, also in this case, two categories. That is the temporal embedding one. In the temporal embedding one, we have that the representation of each node is updated anytime considering the feature of the node, the topology of the graph, and this vector G. This vector is just a functional encoding of the time. So this vector is based on a random Fourier transform. So you have an encoding of the time, and you consider also this encoding of the time together with the node representation and the topology of the graph in order to update the information of the node. The most famous works that use this kind of mechanism are TGAT and NIT. The other categories is the neighborhood mechanism, and in this case we have that these models relies on a special mailbox module that update the node representation based on the event. So you have a function of the event. Once you have calculated the function of this event, you have that you update the representation of each node as a combination of all the event in which the node is involved. There are several methods in these categories. And what we have done later is that, well, there are all these methods that are inside this taxonomy. Let's see what this method can do or cannot do. So as you can see, we take all the possible tasks that I have shown you before, plus other tasks that are less important and for sake of simplicity I've not presented before. And we try to understand which model was made for doing which kind of task. And as you can see, there are a lot of tasks that are not addressed with temporal graph neural networks so far, like, as I said before, clustering or anomaly detection and so on. And as you can see, especially, there are a lot of methods that work for future prediction, but less method that works with past prediction. So starting from this taxonomy, from this table, we can imagine some future direction for temporal graph neural networks. So maybe we can try to apply temporal graph neural networks to create new models, new methods based on graph neural network mechanism that are suitable for solving this particular kind of task. Besides this, we identify some open challenges that can guide the future work on temporal graph neural networks. The first one is the evaluation. So, of course, for static graph neural networks, it's very easy to evaluate different models because there is this OGB dataset that is widely used. Unfortunately, for temporal graph neural networks, all these methods that I presented so far are tested on different datasets, and so it becomes difficult to compare the different temporal graph neural network mechanisms. There is this recent, very important dataset that is the temporal graph benchmark, and we hope that for future work for new temporal graph neural network models, we have to use this dataset in such a way that all the methods can be compared with each other. There is also this other interesting dataset that is proposed by Zhou and other that is very important for scalability because there are two datasets. The biggest one is around 1 billion of temporal ages, and so it can be used also for understanding the scalability properties of temporal graph neural networks. Another thing that is not been explored yet is the explainability on this evaluation. So there are no methods proposed so far that are specifically tailored for trying to understand the decision made by these temporal graph neural networks. Another theoretical properties of temporal graph neural networks is that the expressive power of temporal graph neural network has not been explored a lot so far. So there are some results. So for static graph neural networks, we know that they are at most as powerful as the Masferrer-Lehmann test. We have less results about temporal graph neural networks. We have this result by Bethal-Swisling of 2024 that is basically a universal approximation theorem, but this theorem holds just for snapshot-based temporal graphs, while a complete theory of dynamic Masferrer-Lehmann test and so on for all the different kind of temporal graphs is still lacking. Other problems, other open challenges are the ones related to the learnability. So, for example, the problems of smoothing and of squashing that are widely studied, even if we have not that many solutions for static graphs, they became even more important with temporal dimension because it's even more difficult with long-term dependencies and so on. And finally, we think that there are so many real-world applications that still not be explored with temporal graph neural network. Maybe with other algorithms for temporal graphs, yes, but not with this kind of message passing algorithm. Like, for example, TGNN for regression problem, maybe for climate modeling, epidemic studies, and so on. And this framework can be interesting also to try to propose like the temporal extension of physics-informed neural networks that are this kind of network that try to use both the graph, the neural network approach and the physical knowledge. And in this case, we think that trying to combine these two aspects can be interesting for having more complete and useful applications of temporal graph neural networks. So that's all. And if you have any questions or comments or suggestions, I'm very glad to answer and to hear them. Thank you very much.
Great. Thanks for the great presentation. I think we all learned a lot from the presentation, and it's very clear with the slides and everything. So let's thank the speaker for the presentation. If you have any questions, feel free to type in the chat or just ask here. So to follow up on the like the final slide about the like open challenges, like specifically for the expressiveness, I think it's a completely different setup than what we have for static graph, right? So for static graph, we still have open challenges for how to understand which GNNs are, like how to link the empirical performance with the actual like expressiveness, because some GNNs cannot like can be not very expressive, but they can still perform like really well for the local tasks, for example. So do you have some thoughts on the expressiveness for temporal graph GNNs?
Well, as you said, of course, also for static graph, this is still a very studied problems, because as you said, maybe we have also to understand well the link between expressiveness and the performance on some task. And I think for temporal graphs, it's even more difficult because the first step can be, of course, that of try to formalize the theory of Pasquale Lemantes for dynamic graphs, for different kind of dynamic graphs. But still, I don't know if this can be useful because maybe there are some way of try to study the expressive power that are also better for temporal graph neural networks. So maybe try to develop dynamic counterpart of Pasquale-Lehmann for different kind of temporal graphs can be very difficult. And I don't know if it reflects well the expressive power of this kind network. I think that it's better maybe if we reason about universal approximation theorem. So try to understand which kind of function, in this case, in some cases, it's related to the Pasquale-Lehmann, but not necessarily. And so maybe try to understand which kind of function can the different temporal graph neural network approximate. I think that this can be, so theoretical studies. Universal approximation theorem is one of the most important way of understanding the theoretical properties of temporal graph neural networks.
Yeah, for sure. Like I think that's a very interesting view. Yeah, and go ahead, Zach.
Yeah, I'm wondering if you looked at the tools that people are using. Like whenever I've tried to play with some of this stuff, dealing with either, snapshots are somewhat straightforward, but like the event-based temporal graphs and like how to DGL and PyG are not easy to apply to those sorts of things. So what are people using to do this kind of work?
So there is I have to say I'm not so expert in implementing because I am more for theoretical part, but there are I think some libraries that you can use, but in the paper we mentioned these. So we have this paragraph, and at the beginning, I don't remember the name, but we say something about what to use for implementing this kind of stuff. But yes, of course, I can imagine that for snapshot based, it's way easier, even if the event based I think they are more powerful for some way because they have this temporal information which is directly attached to node and ages. And so the temporal information is so in the snapshot base, in some sense, you lose a little bit of the temporal information because you have these just this a sequence of graphs without having a temporal information on each event. But yeah, actually, I am not able to answer well to you because it's one of my biggest problem is that I not implement a lot and I do other stuff, more theoretical stuff. And so, unfortunately, I don't know how to help you a lot.
So thanks for the question, and so also feel free to send your question in the like on the Slack. Then I think like all the community members, if they have like libraries that they use, they can also share there. But there is like the IGLib like paper from last year, which have some of the state-of-the-art methods, and probably like as mentioned, there's like a ton of references in the paper itself as well. Yes, go ahead, Namin.
Hi everyone. Yeah, I found it really interesting, and I think it's really helpful to have these kind of overview projects because it's just great to kind of know the space and try and compartmentalize it a bit easier. On the kind of topic of real world applications, I guess both for physical knowledge and climate modeling. I know that there's quite a lot of work with GNNs for dynamic systems and for kind of particle based models, including and then there's the kind of extension of that where you have work by Miles Cranmer, where it's looking at kind of symbolic regression to back out the physical model, or the kind of emulator where you have a kind of learned representation, and then using that almost act as a pseudo simulator. I just wonder where those types of applications would fit into both the taxonomy, and also I don't know whether that's kind of, yeah, I guess that's the main one. Where would they kind of sit more broadly in terms of the taxonomy, where you have this emulator-based approach, and then also coupled with potentially some symbolic regression on top?
Yeah, okay. So first of all, I think that you can consider that in this kind of climate stuff, the topology of the graph is somehow fixed. So it's more like spatial-temporal graphs. Okay, so in this case, I think that the models are a little bit different. Maybe you can have a look on these spatial-temporal models that are specifically tailored for dynamical graphs where the structure stay the same, the topology is the same, and the vector, or so maybe you have to give more attention to the dynamics of the feature, so the time series of the feature. And so there are some methods that are specifically tailored for this kind of graphs, and that are even more where, as I said, there is more attention to the evolution of the feature vectors. And so with respect to the topology of the graph, so maybe these methods are more important, and there is a wide range, wide literature about this, and we haven't, since it's like a little bit different stuff, we haven't looked at this in our work, but there are also some surveys about spatiotemporal graphs and also way of working with that.
Perfect. Many thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, and just to bring the chat as well, I think Li Shan from the chat mentioned that the pathogeometric temporal library is an interesting one for the smash-up based models, or the like all the discrete time dynamic graph models. And yeah, so that could be a good starting point as well. Yeah, so is there any other questions from the audience? Okay. Yeah, so thanks for the presentation. There's definitely like a lot of open work to do. I think like one of the most open area that you mentioned like multiple times in the presentation is the disease modeling or the pandemic forecasting part, which have a different distinct literature that don't use GNNs and just use the classical kind of like mathematical models, like the ones that are used in the government, for example, but these are not kind of like neural network based models. So I think like there's a lot of potential to try to learn from past data and then see if we can predict the contact links and so on as well.
Yeah, every so during the COVID, a lot of mathematical models have been used for modeling also the spread of epidemic and so on. But I think that temporal graph neural networks have really a great potential for this kind of application. And yeah, so I totally agree that this is one of the most important applications in which we can do something with temporal graph neural networks.
Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. Yeah, so thanks for presentation again. And then I will see you all in the next week's presentation.
Thank you very much for having invited me. Thank you.
Thank you for the presentation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.